What's happening, everybody? Trey here, joined by my dad, Sean, and today, reactions to the classics. We got a Frank Zappa battle coming to you today, courtesy of our longtime patron and supporter, Seals. Seals, as always, appreciate you, my friend.
Yes, man, always brings great stuff.
Oh, yeah, and a nice eclectic mix of stuff, too, you know? So, I haven't done much Zappa. We actually filmed another song battle for this month for another patron, and that's the first Zappa we've done on the channel.
It is, and it actually had one of these songs, but I said, you know what, let's just do them for both these guys, because, you know, why not?
Yeah, we're going to start with Montana from 1973, and then we're going to do one of his most famous tracks, the opener to Hot Rats, Peaches and Regalia. So be looking forward to that. And let's just start with Montana. It was on Zappa's 1973 record, Overnight Sensation, the last track of the record, and it's one of Zappa's most famous and renowned compositions.
Yeah, it has vocals by the backing vocals by the great Tina Turner and the Iquettes throughout the entire track, notably on the middle and ending sections.
Cool, man. And they were in the studio. They were taking a break next to the studio where this was recorded. Ike wasn't a big fan of what he was hearing in the next studio, as I could only imagine. And he demanded that Zappa not print or give credit on the LP to Tina. If you know anything about Ike, that seems to be in character.
Yeah, that's about right. Yeah.
But Tina really liked her effort, and because they had to do some tricky backgrounds to kind of get what they wanted. So let's enjoy this one, 6.5 minutes.
Yeah, and guys, give it a thumbs up, hit the subscribe, and check out our Patreon link. The patrons keep this thing going. Let's do this, Trey.
Powerful drums starting to set up here.
I might be moving to Montana soon. Just to raise me up a crop of dental floss. Raising it up, waxing it down. In a little white box that I can sell uptown. By myself, I wouldn't have no boss, but I'd be raising my lonely dental floss.
Only Zappa could do this.
I was going to say.
I'd love to be in the room when Tina is saying this.
Yeah, Colin, here's what I need you to say. First discussion would have been fun.
Well, I just might grow me some beans, but I'd leave the sweet stuff to somebody else. But then, on the other hand, I would keep the wax and melt it down, pluck some floss, and swish it around. I'd have me a crop, and it'd be on top. That's why I'm moving to Montana. Moving to Montana soon. Gonna be a dental floss tycoon. Yes, I am. Moving to Montana soon. Gonna be a dental floss
Reminding us how he got here, killing that solo, man. Thank you. I Cats going in.
Wow.
Gonna find me a horse just about this big and ride him all along the borderline with a pair of heavy-duty zircon-encrusted tweezers in my hand. Every other wrangler would say I was mighty grand. By myself, I wouldn't have no balls, but I'd be raising my lonely dental floss.
Raising my lonely dental floss. That marimba coming in.
Yeah. Raising my
lonely dental floss. Well, I might ride along the border with my tweezers gleaming in the moonlight at night. And then I get a cup of coffee and give my foot a push. Just me and the pygmy pony over by the dental floss. And then I might just jump back on and ride like a cowboy into the dawn to Montana.
Into Montana.
Right, Montana, bringing it, man. Zappa and Tina Turner and the I-Cats. Gotta be one of the most unlikely mashups in popular music history right here.
Yeah, you know, when you see the word Montana, I did not expect, I don't know why I would, but it was the most bizarre subject matter. He's going to move to Montana and raise him a crop of dental floss, and then it just plays that out throughout the song. Yeah, I mean, what an interesting choice.
No, man, I really dug the track.
Oh,
man.
I did too.
I thought musically, it again just it highlighted. There was the movements in the song were very impressive. We had some marimba popping up.
Yep.
Obviously, for I think the most impressive was that
solo.
2 minute guitar solo in there.
Yeah.
Just ridiculous. Shows you why Zappa is regarded by many critics as one of the best guitarists of his time. And that just really just gave a. It was kind of funny going in from the subject matter of the dental floss. Then we get this heavy rock and solo, and then we come out of that with the bridge where the I-Cats and Tina are, in this really high register.
They just kept getting faster and faster and higher and higher. They're fucking that old dental floss.
Just the whole concept is absurd, and I think that's one of the things that people like about Zappa. He never takes himself too seriously.
Not at all.
And people relate to that, and then Montana doesn't get a lot of shout outs in tunes.
It really doesn't. I especially wouldn't think it does in rock tunes. Maybe a little country that you and I aren't familiar with, but definitely not on this realm.
And Zappa giving that the shout out and gonna be his own boss, baby. And get on that
pygmy
horse.
Pony, because you don't need a big one, man, if you're just trying to get that dental floss.
Nice and small.
Tweezers are gleaming in the moonlight.
Right.
I mean,
then that outro, the yippee tie, oh, I, that was tight. tight, man.
Moving to Montana.
Very catchy, man.
Yeah, it very much is.
So shout out to Zappa and Tina and the iCats there. Now we're going to the opener off of Hot Rats. Peaches in Regalia here. This was used on a lot of his tours as either the opener or the encore as well. One of his most lauded productions that he did. It even has been included in an underground version of The Real Book, which is a set of jazz sheet music standards.
Yeah.
Which is a big deal in the jazz community there. And it's short and sweet, only 3.5 minutes, but if you've never heard it before, it packs a lot in here.
It does, for sure. I've only heard it once because we had it in a battle. And, interestingly enough, his son Dweezil and of course, Steve Vai did a cover of this. Zappa Play Zappa won a Grammy in 2009 for it.
Staying
so that's
pretty
power. Cool. Underwood killing it, man. Keyboards, saxophone, man, just love that. Peaches in Regalia coming in here, and man, I think the thing that just sticks out to me as I continue to listen to this track is how timeless and almost lively it is. You know, you mm-hmm. listen to some jazz and it feels a bit rigid, or that I kind of have to be maybe in a certain mood right.
for it. Whereas this, man, it's I think because it transitions from instrument to instrument so frequently, it never gets stale.
Yeah, the production and arrangement is tight, and Ian Underwood is the MVP. Ooh. Keyboards, flute, saxophone, clarinet, this man is coming. Everybody else is great too, but you know, less instrumentation on some of his other jazz stuff, mm-hmm. but just every bit as impactful.
Yeah, and I mentioned on the other song battle we did, but in case you didn't watch that, the Zappa was ahead of his time on Hot Rats because he kind of made a custom 16-track recorder, and because he didn't like recording in the studio, so he was able to add in all of these overdubs where at the time it was, you know, probably at max 8-track or
yeah,
whatever.
Yeah, that's what's nice when you're a literal genius yeah, when you come up with these things and put them to work.
And so we were able to get all these awesome overdubs in here on a track like this you know, that's why it's probably been so lauded throughout the decade. So great drumming performance as well. Just really, really enjoyed both of these tunes. So shout out to you, Seals, for bringing this to us. And now it's time for our winner, man. We got Montana against Peaches and Regalia. Gosh, you want me to go first?
Yeah, you go first. It's a tough one because you have the instrumental versus, you know, get us some dental floss.
I know, man. It's like, I really like both of these tunes, though, for different reasons.
I do, too. Same thing.
I like the jazz, you know, instrumental nature of the, you know, Peaches, but Montana, it had that humor. It had the killer backing vocals and just the wonderful, wonderful guitar solo by Zappa in there. But I guess I'm going to give the slight nod just to how expertly produced and arranged Peaches and Regalia is, and I'm going to give the slight nod there, but these are both on my like songs on Spotify.
Yeah, and I was hoping you would make that choice, Trey, because I'm going to go with Montana.
Ooh,
even though I do see both. I mean, it's, you know, it shows, number one thing it shows that can't be lost is just the diversity of Zappa and truly being able to do anything he wants to do. So no. I really enjoyed that one.
Yeah, this is one that there are no losers here,
no.
You know. But let us know which of these you liked more down in the comment section below, y'all. As always, Dad, appreciate it.
Yeah.
Appreciate you, Seals,
thanks,
bringing this to us. And until next time, y'all, thanks for watching. Happy listening, and we will see you.